We're here in Yerevan, Armenia this week, right on our public square to bring you your latest crypto capsule, the weekly recap of all the developments in the global crypto ecosystem that you need to know. And all this in less than 60 seconds. Here we go. Let's start in Hong Kong, where regulators issued new guidance for crypto fund managers that provide flexibility when it comes to custody and bank account requirements, but that strengthen requirements on risk management and independent audit. In the US, the IRS issued their first crypto tax guidance in over 5 years. The revised ruling came with a list of over 40 FAQ questions, providing clarity not only on essential questions like the tax treatment of crypto assets, but also more specific scenarios like hard forks and airdrops. On the regulatory front, the US SEC rejected Bitwise's Bitcoin ETF proposal. However, the SEC mentioned that their disapproval does not rest on evaluation on whether Bitcoin or blockchain have utility or value, but rather that the legal requirements with regards to the prevention of fraud and market manipulation were not met. Separately, after having stated that it sees Bitcoin as a commodity in 2015, the CFTC confirmed that it also views Ether as a commodity and that forked assets should be treated in the same way from a regulatory perspective as their original asset. And finally, some US senators wrote a letter to the CEOs of Stripe, Visa, and MasterCard, asking them to pull out of Facebook's Libra and warning them that if they still decide to be involved, they should expect a high-level scrutiny from regulators, not only on Libra-related payments, but on all payment activities. Well, that's all for this week, folks, and see you all next week from somewhere in the world.